Hello, hello guys, I am Zakaria, the ghostwriter. After watching the video on TikTok about, you know, the lightning was struck in ZCC, I had to dig deep and, you know, try to see if maybe the story is out there, if many people are going to report about the story, because when it comes to these sensitive, you know, stories, you need to pay attention and look at different platforms and see if you can get more people who are verifying the story. So I went on Facebook and I saw this other post and it says ZCC pastor. The pastor died after being struck by lightning while in a church service. He was from Hanchavilin Jain Fest. Now it's been confirmed that the person who passed away as a pastor, and may his soul rest in peace. And to be honest, you know, things changed now. Things are no longer the same, you know, especially after COVID-19. You know, it is so difficult, you know, and I know that others are still in the hospital, and I know that it's tough, especially to family members who, you know, got the news that their loved ones are in hospital. And also especially for, you know, the family of the pastor who just lost, you know, his life. You know, it is difficult. It is difficult, and they will all not know if maybe it will be safe today, as I'm recording this Friday, if it will be safe for them to even go to church next month, because I know how things work. If the person just died this week, or last week, that simple means that the whole month of January, there won't be a church service in that church. You know, there won't be any service. And they have to report this, and it has to go to Moriya, and the office in Moriya has to also, you know, release a statement, and maybe we will know how long that church will be closed before they have a service again in that church. Maybe it might be closed permanently, maybe it might be closed maybe for 3 months, we don't know. But we know that, you know, they will take time before they will allow people, you know, to go there and pray and perpetually die. You know, it's a sad story, and it shows that there is more vulnerable, you know, in the church, which has always been there, whereby people are competing for positions. You know, a certain pastor, why can he have this type of a position while the other has been in church for many years? There is always been more vulnerable, and we always knew about, you know, that. You know, we always knew about people competing about certain seats and certain positions, because once they are in certain seats and certain positions, they are in the position of power whereby they can start, you know, benefiting from those type of stuff. And don't forget that even if, you know, we know that, you know, in ZCC, it's not like any other churches whereby people get a huge amount of money or paycheck every month. But still, you know, there is still certain stuff like why this one is being assigned to take this certain trip to these other places. Others are not assigned, because every time there is a certain trip, maybe with the bus, there will be two pastors who are assigned to go with the congregants to go to a certain place. If there is a funeral, if there is a, there is anything which means, you know, the church to be there, you know, in case if a church member passed away, going to a funeral, then they has to, you know, take out buses, and obviously there has to be certain pastors who will be accompanying, you know, the congregants to that, you know, service, and there will be the certain pastor who will be running the service, you know, and those type of stuff like that, without going deep into, you know, a lot of things that, you know, members will want, that the pastors has the power to bless and the power to pray over, you know what I'm saying? So it is one of those things, and we don't know the cause of the whole thing that happened, but we know that there has been Movango all along, you know, and maybe this will be that moment where we were told that, you know, two churches will get together and become one. I think we are getting closer and closer to that space. I remember I made a video when I said, will ZTC go digital? You know, people were angry on the comment section. But if you sit down and you pay attention, you will see that it's slowly going digital, as you see Time Bank there, as you see now the ATMs, we know that they've been there all along. And we know that, you know, sooner you know, they will start using the cutlass transition. I'm not going to talk much, but I know that already, you know, it looks like that thing of people buying in cash, you find cash everywhere. It's not going to be there anymore. You know, it's going to go digital whereby you will use your card when you're buying stuff there. You will just tap and get whatever that you want to buy in Moria. You know, it's getting there. You know, it's getting there. It's getting there to that, you know, digital space, obviously. And most people, obviously, on Facebook, they have their say, they comment the way they want to comment. And others are saying ever since COVID-19, you know, the chat is no longer the same. You know, and yeah, it's one of those difficult times. And for people who pray, you know, it's an eye-opening. It's an eye-opening to those who are not even seeing what was actually going on, so that they will know that you need to pray. You cannot even rely on a certain pastor to come and put hands on you so that they can bless, you know, certain stuff in your life. You have to learn to pray for yourself. You have to learn to understand how certain things work. You know, and yeah, man. It's one of those stories that I never thought I would see. And obviously, I had to sit down and think about making videos and talking about this. But obviously, we have to talk about these things, you know. We have to talk about these things. You know, and I just don't understand why Cyril, let me keep quiet. You know, because, yeah. I appreciate you guys for your love and support. Thank you.